pi by omega, 2 pi by omega. These, all these points are very, very important. Total signals and system based on these only two signals. The majority of the signals and system based on the only two signals. One is sensorial signals and another one is impulse. And another one is impulse. About the impulse you will see. You will see in the next lesson maybe. Okay, sin omega t is equal to 2 pi by omega. This is periodic, period is equal to 2 pi by omega. And one more point is that the spectrum of this, the frequency spectrum of the sinusoidal signal is having only one frequency, only one frequency. All these you will see in the Fourier series, no problem. The spectrum of the sinusoidal signal is having only one frequency. And one more thing is that the differentiation and the integration, of the sinusoidal signal is sinusoidal only. The differentiation and integration of the sinusoidal signal is the sinusoidal only. The sinusoidal only. First point is that of the sinusoidal signals, one is the A cos 2 pi ft plus theta and another one is the A sin 2 pi ft plus theta. These two are treated as the sinusoidal signals. The corresponding amplitude A is taken as the magnitude amplitude. If they ask you instantaneous amplitude, the corresponding instantaneous amplitude means amplitude of the signal at particular time interval, at particular instant of time, the corresponding is your instantaneous amplitude. And this phi is nothing but signal is having the frequency 5 hertz, then you have to consider f is equal to 5. If signal is having the frequency 5 radian per second, then you have to consider the corresponding omega. So this omega is equal to 2 pi f. So omega is equal to 2 pi f, and the corresponding theta is equal to omega t, where theta is in the radians, and this pi is the phase. If suppose the sinusoidal signal is start from like this, this corresponding is called your phase. The corresponding is called your phase of the signal. This is your phase. If the signal is drawn like this, the corresponding is your phase of the signal pi. And next one is that out of this cos and sine, out of the first question is, first point is that about this signal, about the parameters of the signal. And the second point is that out of this cos and sine, which one is leads cos and sine, which one is leads cos leads sine by 90 degrees. Cos leads sine by the phase offered by the cos is 0 and the phase offered by the sine is minus 90 degrees. Then this sinusoidal signal is the symmetrical about the x-axis. The condition is that equal area in magnitude but opposite in the direction. That is nothing but if it is positive, then it is a negative. A1 is equal to minus A2. So that the total area is equal to 0. From this, you can conclude that the area under the sinusoidal signal over one period is always 0. Then coming to the next one, the spectrum of the sinusoidal signal is having only one frequency. And differentiation and integration of the sinusoidal leads to the sinusoidal only. Suppose if you consider y is equal to sine theta, then there is only one full cycle from the 0 to 2 pi. If you consider sin omega t, there are omega number of cycles in 0 to 2 pi. Each cycle having the period is equal to 2 pi by omega. And same information is repeated. For 0 to 2 pi is repeating up to minus infinity, So we can treat this signal as a periodic signal. If the period is equal to 2 pi by omega. These points we have to remember with respect to the sinusoidal point of view at this level. Then next one. Your sampling function. Sampling function is nothing but sampling of KT. Sin KT divided by KT. Expression is equal to sin KT divided by KT. For what values? This will be 0. For what values? The graph should be of the like this only. That is, as T tending to 0, here KT tending to 0. Sin theta by theta is equal to limit. Theta tending to 0. Sin theta by theta is equal to 1 only answer. So, but t equal to 0, this value is equal to 1. And for what values of the shape of this one is like this, graph is like this. For what values of t, this will be 0. Whenever this kt is equal to n pi. Or this t is equal to n pi by k. That is nothing but n equal to 1 pi by k. Then 2 pi by k like this. Minus 2 pi by k like that. These are the points where No, these are the points with called the zero crossover. Zero crossover. The values of E where it is crossing the zero axis is called the zero crossovers. The corresponding zero crossovers are adjacent to pi by k, 2 pi by k, like that. And this is called your main lobe. Main lobe of the signal is called the main lobe of the signal. In this, 90% of this information is present in this main lobe only. In the analysis point of view, we will consider this main lobe only. Analysis point of view, we will consider this main lobe only. Now coming to sync function, this is a small modification of this one, is our sync function. This sync kt is equal to sync function, this is about the sampling function. Then sync function, sync kt is equal to simply sin pi kt divided by pi kt, sin pi kt divided by pi kt. That is nothing but sync t is equal to, we can write sampling of pi t, you can write sync t is equal to sampling of pi t. Here already we have seen sync pi, sync kt can be represented as the sampling of pi kt, sampling of pi kt. So the shape is almost like same only, this simply sampling function only, shape is also same only, only difference is that the zero crossover, the existence of the zero crossovers. Zero crossover equation, whenever this pi kt is equal to n pi, pi by will get cancelled and t equal to n by k. So 1 by k, 2 by k, 3 by k, like that. Here also minus 1 by k, minus 2 by k and minus 3 by k. These are the zero crossovers. Everything is similar to that of the sampling only. As sampling function we call, this is the main lobe of the signal. So here also we call this is the main lobe of the signal and 90% of the information is existing in this main lobe. Analysis point of view, we will consider this one only. Either sampling function or sync function, you have to remember. But this also plays a very very important role in the signals and systems. On the sampling and every year we are having one 2-mass question on the sampling in the Fourier transform. Okay, every year we are having one 2-mass question. Okay, no problem. We will see everything. At this level, you have to remember, you have to know about the sampling function. You have to know about sampling function. Sampling function is nothing but whenever you see the sampling, the corresponding shape and the corresponding zero crossover, what values, this will be zero, and what is the value at t equal to zero, we have to get an idea about that in your mind. Whenever you listen the term sampling, the correspondingly, whenever you listen the term sync also. And the modulus function already we have seen, the corresponding modulus function already we have seen is equal to x. For x less than 0 is equal to minus x, for x less than 0, x greater than 0. Similarly, you have seen also the step function. No need to discuss about this one. Modulus and the step function, no need to discuss. And then coming to your exponential signal, that is e to the power minus at or e to the power minus t, you can consider. E to the power minus t and e to the power t in discrete point of view, a to the power n with a greater than 1 and with a less than 1. In discrete point of view, with a greater than 1 and a less than 1. Try to draw this graph, e power minus t, by considering t equal to from minus infinity to minus infinity. Try to draw this graph. Yeah, t is by considering the t is from minus infinity to infinity. What is the graph of this e to the power minus t? This is called exponential sequence in continuous form and the corresponding in the discrete form. So this value is equal to e to the power minus infinity, e to the power infinity is equal to infinity, and e to the power minus infinity is equal to 0, you have to remember. E to the power infinity is equal to infinity, and e to the power minus infinity equal to 0, you have to remember, and a to the power infinity is equal to infinity when a is greater than 1. This value is equal to 0 when a is less than 1. E power infinity is infinity, e power minus infinity is 0, and this a power infinity is equal to infinity when a is greater than 1. Like that only, 2 power infinity if we consider 2 square, that is 4, 2 cube, that is 8, 2 power 4, that is 16, 2 power 4, that is going on increasing. So if 2 power infinity, that will be infinity. If a is less than 1, if you consider 1 by 2 whole square, 1 by 4, 1 by 2 whole cube, 1 by 8, 1 by 2 power 1 by 16, like that. If you keep on increasing, that it goes to 0.000, like that will become 0. So a to the power infinity, this value, a less than 1, this value will be 0. Now coming to this first one, a power e to the power minus t. At t equal to minus infinity, minus of e to the power minus infinity, this value is equal to infinity. So this slope going on increasing, at t equal to 0, this value is equal to 1. And at t equal to infinity, this value is going to be 0. This is the corresponding signal, e to the power minus t. This is the corresponding signal, e to the power minus t. If you consider e to the power t, e power minus infinity is equal to 0, e power minus infinity equal to 0, and e to the power infinity is going to be infinity. This is the corresponding value at t equal to 0. Now coming to this a to the power n. A to the power n is nothing but, n is nothing but, you have only the integer values of n. At n equal to infinity, if a is greater than, I am considering at n equal to minus infinity, at n equal to minus infinity, definitely this will be 1 by a over to 1 infinity is equal to 0 only. Equal to 0 only. So this starts like this, starts like this. At n equal to 0, this value is equal to 1, and going on increasing up to infinity. If n is equal to infinity, this value is going to be infinity. This is the expression for the a to the power n with a greater than 1. If a is less than 1, as n going to be infinity, this value is equal to 0. So this starts like this. The value at n equal to 0 is equal to 1, and it is going on increasing up to infinity in this direction. This is our a to the power n. The total continuous is depending on this e power minus t, and the total discontinuous signal is based on the a to the power, based on this a to the power n. Total Fourier transform is based on this e to the power minus t. Calculations are everything we will see, e power minus t, and in Z transform and the in DTFT like that, we have a to the power n. So we should have some information about this a to the power n and the this one. Which one? Exponential signal e to the power minus t. Then coming to rectangular pulse and the triangular pulse. I am considering here either rectangular pulse is nothing but the format is equal to like this, rectangle of e by tau with amplitude is equal to a, interact with amplitude is equal to a, then the corresponding signal is equal to whatever they have given. Here is equal to, here is your width, here is your width. This tau is equal to width, and this to be symmetrically with respect to the y-axis. Here width is equal to tau is nothing but, so this is equal to minus tau divided by 2 to tau divided by 2, minus tau divided by 2 to tau divided by 2, whatever they have given, this to be taken as the width. So minus tau by 2 to tau by 2, and corresponding amplitude is equal to 1. This is your f of t, a into rectangle of t by tau, called the rectangular pulse. Oh, in different books, in different manner, they will give you, in examination, they will clearly give you what is the magnitude and what is the corresponding width you have to consider. Clearly, they will give you, no problem. The question they will mention, no problem. Okay, suppose if you consider the pulse equal to 5 into rectangle of 2t, how can you represent this one? This can be represented as a 5 into rectangle of t by 1 by 2, whatever the denominator here, you have to consider as the corresponding width. So that is nothing but is from minus 1 by 4 to 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4 to 1 by 4, this is equal to 1 by 2 is equal to width. So corresponding width of this one is equal to 2 by 4, which is equal to 1 by 2, and amplitude is equal to 5. Like this we have to write. Suppose I am considering a rectangular pulse. Of like this, which is equal to minus a by 2 to a by 2, and the corresponding amplitude with unit area. I am considering the unit area rectangular pulse with width is equal to a. For making this unit area, corresponding amplitude is equal to a into a. What is width of this one? A into a is equal to 1, so it is equal to 1 by a. If you consider the area, the amplitude is equal to 1 by a, the corresponding area of this signal is equal to 1 by a into a, which is equal to 1, and this can be represented as the 1 by a rectangular of t divided by whatever the width you have, that is the signal. 1 by a rectangle of t divided by a. This is the signal for the representation of the unit area rectangular pulse. I am taking this limit as t a tending to 0. What will happen to this signal? Is equal to simply the limits are going to be 0. And the amplitude is going to be infinity. Here width is going to be reduces and amplitude is going to be increases. Listen carefully. Width is going to be reduces and amplitude is going to be increases. What is actually area is equal to x into y, where x width into height actually. Here a is going to be 0, is nothing but this width is going to be 0, and correspondingly amplitude is going to be increases. So this overall omega is going to be reduces and height is going to be increases correspondingly. So the area is always constant only. Even the signal, if you consider limit a tending to 0 of this one, the corresponding limit corresponding is equal to width is going to be 0, which is going to be 0, and the corresponding amplitude is going to be infinity. Even the area is equal to 1 only, area equal to constant 1 only, because of this one. As area equal to width into height, width is reduces, height is increases, area is always constant only. The corresponding signal is called the unit impulse signal, represented by del of t, represented by del of t, which is equal to, which is having the value only at t equal to 0. The other values of t equal to 0, this value is equal to 0, and at t equal to 0, this value is going to be infinity. This value is going to be infinity, some value, some not defined value equal to 0. So we can call the corresponding is called a unit impulse signal. Unit impulse signal. If I consider the unitary impulse, instead of unitary impulse, I am considering the impulse whose area is equal to 2. I am considering the impulse whose area is equal to 2. That is nothing but minus a by 2 to a by 2, with amplitude is equal to 2 by a, the corresponding area is equal to 2 by a into a, which is equal to 2. For this question, if you consider the corresponding a is going to be 0, the corresponding a is going to be 0, this width is going to be 0, and height is going to be infinity, but area is constant at 2 only, but area is equal to 2, but area is constant at 2 only, the corresponding signal is called the 2 into del of t, 2 into del of t, because 2 is called the strength of the impulse. This 2 is represented as the strength of this impulse. Here, the strength of the impulse is equal to 1, the corresponding is equal to 1 into del of t. Here, the corresponding strength is equal to 2. So, the corresponding impulse can be represented as the 2 into del of t. Representation called the strength of the impulse. 2 is not an amplitude of the impulse. Remember, carefully. This 2 is not an amplitude of the impulse. This 2 is strength of the impulse. Okay, strength of the impulse is nothing but area under this impulse is equal to 2. Here the area under this impulse, integration del of t dt is equal to 1. Here what is the area under this one? Area under this one is equal to integration del of t dt is equal to 2, because this area of this rectangular pulse is equal to 2. This 2 into del of t was evolved from the rectangular pulse of area is equal to 2 units. Rectangular pulse of area is equal to 2 units, so corresponding is equal to strength of the impulse. So you can represent this del of t is equal to 0 for t not equal to 0, and this is not equal to 0 for t equal to 0, not equal to 0 for t is equal to 0, t equal to 0. If we write the corresponding signal representation is equal to like this, equal to 1 is nothing but unit area impulse, unit impulse. The corresponding is equal to 1, this is equal to 1, corresponding del of t, whose amplitude don't know at t, defined only at t equal to 0, at some value which is not equal to 0, or other than the values of t equal to 0, this value will be 0. If suppose they represented the signal is equal to like this, which is equal to 2, the corresponding signal is equal to 2 into del of t. This 2 is not an amplitude, this 2 is the strength of the impulse or area under the impulse. So this 2 into del of t was evolved from the rectangular pulse of area is equal to 2 unit, of area is equal to 2 square units. That is all you have to remember. Okay, this 2 not an amplitude, again and again I am telling to you. But if you go to the discontinuous point of view, the del of n is perfectly definable and amplitude is equal to 1. And amplitude is equal to 1, at that time again we will discuss. Now, this is about the impulse from the rectangular signal. Now, rectangular pulse. Now, we will see the triangular pulse. You will see the next one is the triangular pulse. Remember, rectangular pulse, then triangular pulse. The representation is equal to single to the rectangular pulse only, which is equal to A into triangular of T divided by tau. Earlier case, it was A into rectangular of T by tau. The corresponding denominator, whatever you have, that was considered as the width of the pulse. Now here, this is our triangular pulse. The corresponding tau to be considered as the width divided by 2. Corresponding tau to be considered as the width divided by 2. So the corresponding width is equal to 2 tau. Corresponding width is equal to 2 tau, and it will be symmetrical about the y-axis. To make this width is equal to 2 tau, this is equal to minus tau 2 tau. This is equal to minus tau 2 tau, and corresponding amplitude is equal to A. So this can be represented as A into 1 minus mod t by tau. The expression is equal to A into 1 minus mod t by tau. No need to remember this one. Simply by the coordinate system you can write what is the slope of this one. Slope of this one is equal to y2 minus y1 is equal to A minus 0 divided by 0 minus of minus 1 is equal to a by tau. Now by writing y minus 0 is equal to m into x minus x1, y minus 0 is equal to m into x minus x1, like that we can get the same expression only, 1 minus 40 by tau. Don't bother about this expression. Here the importance is that importance is the drawing of the shape. Drawing of the shape. A into rectangle of t by tau is equal to, if you write, if you having the shape of this one, directly you can write, if suppose I am conjuring, this is the tau is equal to minus 1. This tau is equal to minus 1 and amplitude is equal to 1. Tau is equal to minus 1 and amplitude is equal to minus 1. How can I write expression? Yes, slope is equal to 1 minus 0 divided by 1 minus 0 divided by 0 of minus 1 is equal to 1 and y minus 0 is equal to slope into m into x minus x1. M into x minus x1 is equal to m into t minus of minus 1 is equal to t plus 1. T plus 1. M into x minus x1 is equal to t plus 1. So this above this expression is equal to your t plus 1 and corresponding is equal to minus t plus 1. That one I have given is equal to 1 minus 40 divided by tau. 1 minus 40 divided by tau. Here tau is equal to 1. Here tau is equal to 1. This will become, for the values of negative, this mod tau will become negative. So this will become 1 plus t. 1 plus t, this is only one having, and if for positive values this will become positive only, so that will become 1 minus 2, that only you are having, that only you are having. Further, what is the necessity of remembering? What is the necessity of remembering? Ignoring. Okay, already you are having expression, but already you have how to form the pulse for the rectangle of e by tau. With that knowledge only, you can draw the pulse of this one. Already we know how to draw the pulse of the rectangle. With the knowledge of drawing this pulse of the rectangle, we can write the pulse for the triangle also. Pulse for the triangle also. What is the necessity of remembering the expressions and from the expression writing something? Know it. Okay, this tau can be represented as the minus tau only. Suppose the signal is of like this triangular of 2t. 5 into triangular of 2t. Then we can, what is the corresponding pulse you have to write? This is equal to 5 into triangular of t divided by 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is equal to your width by 2. So corresponding width is equal to 1 only. We can write this is minus 1 by 2 to 1 by 2. Corresponding amplitude is equal to 5. This is only the corresponding triangular pulse. Now I am considering here also the unit area triangular pulse. Minus 1 to 1 is equal to 1 half into base into height, which is equal to 1. Half into base into height, which is equal to 1. I am considering here as the minus a, here as the a. And what is the value of amplitude? What is the value of amplitude to make this as the unit area? This is equal to this half into base 2a into height is equal to 1. This we have cancelled and a is equal to 1 by a. This a will become 1 by a. This a will become 1 by a. The corresponding signal can be represented as the 1 by a triangle of t divided by 2a. This is your corresponding signal. Now again I am writing. These are the limit a tending to 0. This value is going to be 0. And the amplitude is going to be infinity. But by maintaining this area as constant, because this area is equal to half into base into height only. Half into base into height, as base is going to be reduces, H is going to increase correspondingly. So to make the product BH is equal to constant, so area is equal to constant. So as A tending to 0, this value width is going to be 0, but area is, but amplitude is going to be infinity, but area is always constant only. The corresponding signal is represented as a del of t only. So del of t you can derive from the triangular pulse also, not only from the rectangular pulse, from the triangular pulse also. If you consider the triangular pulse of area is equal to two square units, the triangular pulse of area is equal to 2 square units, this will become 2 by a. Then if a tending to 0, this will become the signal amplitude going to be infinity and width is going to be 0 and the strength of this impulse is equal to 2. So corresponding signal can be represented as 2 into del of t. Remember, this 2 into del of t, 2 is not an amplitude. This 2 is an area. Area under this curve. Then finally, we can represent the area under this curve 2 into del of t from minus infinity is equal to 2 square units. Okay, and we can conclude the corresponding signal, impulse del of t is equal to 0 for t not equal to 0. And area is equal to 1. This also you have to write along with the definition of this impulse. Area under this impulse is equal to 1. That is nothing but integration minus infinity del of t dt is equal to 1. Del of t is equal to minus infinity del of